Hi there. My name is Ross McDonald. I'm a solutions engineer here at Kong. Today, we'll be doing a quick demonstration of how you can approach APIOps with an end-to-end automation framework. During this demo, we'll show how you can leverage Kong's declarative configuration tool, called decK, to update your API configurations in a smooth and automation-friendly way. From there, we'll show how you can tie decK into a CI/CD framework for automating updates in the same way you update and deliver code. The goal here is not only just to show how easy it is to automate these updates, but also that you can consistently and fearlessly deploy services with a few simple commands using the tools you already use today. With the automation out of the way, we'll then show how you can apply policy and govern your services in the exact same way. With that, let's get started. Now, before we jump into the CLI, I wanted to do a very brief introduction to decK. decK is Kong's declarative configuration tool. And this is what allows you to capture the state of your configuration in YAML format, allows you to detect any changes between your local configuration and the one running in Konnect, and then lastly, it allows you to synchronize your configuration with the Konnect version. As you can see here on the diagram, we have four discrete steps. First is to capture the snapshot of our Konnect configuration. We're going to then update that state file that gets persisted with the changes we want to make. That could be creating a new service, updating a plugin configuration, anything that lives with inside of the Konnect interface. We can then run a decK diff command to compare what we have locally versus what's inside of Konnect to ensure that the configurations have not drifted in an unexpected way. Then lastly, assuming we didn't identify anything problematic, we'll synchronize those changes back into the control plane, which will then push those changes to the data planes, which are the API gateways running the actual traffic. So the goal is to take these simple building blocks, capture, update, compare, and synchronize, and tie them into our automation pipeline, which you can then include into your existing source control and automation tooling, tie even further into existing change management and governance processes that you already have in place. So for a quick example of how we can tie these basic pieces together, let's say we want to update a configuration in one of our plugins. I'm going to go over here to Konnect, look at one of my payment services here. Here is the service definition for this version. And you can see we have a number of plugins enabled. Let's say we wanted to disable one of the plugins. So for that, I'm going to open up Visual Studio Code. From here, I can run a decK Konnect dump command. This is going to capture the state of the configuration as it lives inside of Konnect and write it to a local YAML file. If I open up this YAML file, we can see the state that we have persisted inside of the Konnect control plane. So here are the services that I have defined. I've got a number of versions for the payment service, as well as a number of plugins. And as an example, let's say I want to disable the bot detection plugin. So under enabled, I'll simply set that to false, save the file. Jumping back to our diagram, I've just performed an update. Now let's compare those changes with what's currently living in Konnect to make sure that the things we want to have updated are actually going to be updated. For that, I can run a diff command. Here you can see that we've detected one change. Enabled true was set previously. Now it's enabled false. We have one artifact that's being updated. That looks good, so let's save it. To synchronize our changes, which is the last step here, we're going to run a decK Konnect sync command. All right, the change has been persisted. Now if I refresh the screen in the Konnect interface, go down to my plugins, you'll see the pod detection plugin is now disabled. So just as we've shown, we've captured the state as it lives inside of Konnect, we've performed an update, we ran a comparison, and then we synchronized the changes. For a more concrete example of what this might look like, I have a GitHub repository configured with GitHub's action CI/CD functionality that we can use for pushing a policy update to Konnect. So imagine I'm a stakeholder for the Payments API service currently deployed. After speaking with our operations team, it turns out the backend service is struggling to keep up with the current request load. So they've asked that we lower the rate limit to ensure stability of the backend service. Easy enough. For that, I'm going to start by opening up Visual Studio Code. Here we can see the state file as it was pulled from Konnect. I found my payment service, and here's my rate limit plugin. If I expand this, I can see the configuration. You'll note that it's currently set to 5 per second. Let's say we wanted to lower this to 2 per second. First is I'll update the state file. As you can see, we've just made a change from 5 to 2. As part of the repository settings, I can't push to the deploy branch specifically, so I'll have to create a pull request. So I'll say chore reduce rate limit. I'm going to add my changes, commit them, and then pushing them to GitHub. With my changes pushed, I can then open a pull request. But before I do that, I wanted to take a quick look at the GitHub workflow that we have defined. As you can see here, we're using a self-hosted runner, which I have running here in the background, just for example purposes. Here it is, and I'll even expand that just a little bit. And all we're actually doing is running a decK Konnect sync. So a very easy and straightforward pipeline for updating the changes. You can also include drift detection inside of the pipeline here to ensure that there's no changes that have been made out of band. But for the example here today, we're just going to apply the change via pull request. Here's my branch. I'm going to change this to the deploy branch. And here's my change. Create the pull request. In this case, I could have enforced reviewers as well as different checks to ensure that this was being done properly. However, since it's just me in this repository, I'll go ahead and merge. If I jump back to my runner here in the background, as it receives the notification for the deploy, it's going to automatically run the series of steps. In this case, just applying that deck configuration. So if I jump over here to the Konnect interface, look at my rate limiting plugin, I can see the rate limit has now been reduced to 2 per second, just like I had asked. And if I go back to my service version, you'll start to see already that the change has been taking effect. And now clients are starting to see 429 errors being returned. So what have we done? Well, we've shown how you can leverage the decK CLI tool to declaratively capture, compare, and apply updates to your Konnect configuration, which then gets persisted to the runtimes. We then showed how you can tie that back into your CI/CD framework for performing end-to-end updates while keeping your configuration within a source code repository. This allows you to leverage your existing change control processes already in place and deliver policy updates and other configuration changes, just like you deliver code. This in turn improves governance, consistency, and stability for your teams without any of the hassle. Thank you so much for watching this quick demo of Kong Konnect. For more information, go to konghq.com. Until next time.